Hi, AT from CNC at home. I want to play around a little bit in LightBurn. There's a feature that they added a few revisions back that I wanted to highlight. It's found under Tools, and it's called Create QR Code. That's an interesting feature. The first thing you have to do is define where you want your QR code. Since it's done with vectors, it really doesn't matter where you put it. You can shrink it, expand it, and it stays perfect. Now, there are three different types of QR codes you can create. You can do a raw content, so you could type in up to 2,000 characters, and that's in the QR code. You can create a Wi-Fi identification, essentially with the password, so if you have people come to your house, instead of them having to find the SSID that's being broadcast, enter the password and the encryption type, they can just scan the QR code, and they're into your network. There's also a contact option. This would be kind of cool from a business standpoint. If somebody wanted your contact information, you could just have a QR code that you showed them, whether that's on a coaster, laser burned into some wood, or wherever. This would be kind of a cool way to do that. They all pretty much work the same way for the contact. You just type in your first and last name, your address, your phone, any notes you want to have in there, your email address, a URL. Pretty straightforward. Same with the Wi-Fi if you know what the name of your SSID is. So my secret network. This isn't really the name of it. And then whatever your password is. So 123QWER456. Say that's the password. You just click OK, and then that creates the QR code. I'm going to switch to a different layer so that it's actually filled in. And that's all there is to it. So as we can see, this is one object that we can move around. It's drawn as vectors, so we can make it bigger and smaller so that it does what we need it to. If we're going to be doing a coaster, we know our coaster is 108 millimeters, so we could make it just slightly smaller than that. Let's call it 106 millimeters. And then we can bring that down into the corner, and we know the center of our coaster, which is 108 millimeters, would be 54 and 54, so that would center it down here. So that's kind of a neat thing to do. Now, if you even just have your phone, if it understands QR codes, you can test it out just by trying to, you know, take a picture of this. You don't actually have to take the picture. You just hold your phone up there, and most of the newer phones will recognize this as a QR code and then translate that. And then you can hit the action button. So pretty cool, pretty straightforward. Again, that's under the Tools option here in LightBurn, and it's called Create QR Code. I'm going to make a coaster out of this that does my real information for the local network. So when people come to visit, they can just scan that, and they're logged in. I may look into creating a guest account first. I don't know. Anyway. This is how you do this in LightBurn. Pretty cool.
As with most burns, the first thing I'll do is press the Shift key and then the Frame button within LightBurn. That'll draw a nice frame around my burning area to make sure that I have the laser and the tile set where I want them to be. Here's the tile once the paint's been cleaned off. The next step will be to put the cork back on. Then it'll go back to the laser and have the logo etched on. Now when I have guests come over, they can easily get attached to the network. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you liked it, give it a thumbs up. And if you like the content that we produce, think about subscribing to the channel. It really helps us out. Have fun doing your CNC at home projects.
Oops.